Today we're going to take a look at a very common task when it comes to cleaning data. And it's also a very common interview question that you might get if you're applying for a data or financial analyst type of job. How can you remove duplicates in your data? I'm going to show you three methods. It's important that you understand the advantages and disadvantages of the different methods and why one of these methods might return a different result to the other ones. Let's take a look. Okay, so I have this table with sales agent, region, and sales value. I want to remove the duplicates that occur in this table. But first of all, what are the duplicates? Well, if we take a look at this row, for example, and take a look at this one, is this a duplicate? No, right? Because the sales value is different. But what about this one and this one? These are duplicates. What I want to happen is that every other occurrence of this line is removed. I just keep it once in the end result. This means that I need to take a look at the combination of all the columns in order to be able to identify duplicates. Now, the first example that I'm going to show you is going to work in all Excel versions. But first, you need to make a decision. Do you want to keep the original dataset or not? If you want to keep it so you can compare before and after, you should create a copy of it. So I'm going to press Ctrl A. Let's press it again to also include the headers and press Ctrl C to copy this. Now let's go to the side here. I'll paste these values and also paste the formatting as well. Okay, so now I can just click somewhere inside this data set, go to the Data tab, under Data Tools here, there is a feature called Remove Duplicates. Just click on it. It's going to try and pick out your data range. In my case, it's correct. There is an automatic check mark here for me to specify that the data has headers. If yours doesn't pick up the headers properly, you can just place a check mark here yourself. The columns involved are fine, so I'm going to click on OK. 5 duplicate values found and removed. 14 unique values remain. Now let's take a look. I just have one occurrence of this combination. Okay, so in case you just want to remove the duplicates of one column, so let's say you want a distinct list of sales agents, you can repeat this process just on the sales agent column. So I'll just show you how that's done. I'm going to copy this, go to the side here. Let's just paste this in. You also don't really need the header in this case. You can select your range or just click somewhere inside the range and go to remove duplicates. I'm going to place a check mark here. My data has headers and click on OK. And this time 15 duplicate values were found and removed and I end up with 4 sales agents. Okay, so that's how you can apply it to a specific column. That was method 1. Now let's take a look at method 2. This method uses formulas and it's something you can use if you have Office 365. This, of course, works on the web version of Excel, so if you have a free Office account, you can use these formulas on Excel on the web. Start with equals. The function we need is the unique function. So this is one of the newer functions in Office 365. All we need is the array, and the array is our table. So just click to the side of the table till you see that tilted arrow. Then click, it's going to pick up your entire table. Mine is called T-Sales. That's all I need. Close bracket, press enter, and I have my unique list. So I've removed duplicates from this data set. Now I'm just going to copy and paste the headers here, and let's just apply the number formatting to these as well. Now the advantage of using a function instead of the first method that I showed you is that the second method here is dynamic. This means if I add data to the bottom of my table, it's automatically going to be reflected with this version. Let's test this. I'm going to copy this and paste it here. Well, right now we're not going to see anything because duplicates are automatically removed. But if I change this number to, let's say, 40, it automatically shows up here. Whereas with this method, I would have to repeat the steps to get my unique list. Okay, so now let's take a look at the third way of doing this. I'm just going to press Ctrl Z a few times to go back to our data set. The third way is with Power Query. Now this method is semi-dynamic because all you have to do is press refresh. Let's take a look. I'm going to go to the Data tab here. This time, instead of going to the Data Tools section, we're going to go to the Get and Transform Data. First of all, Power Query needs to get the data, and then we can transform it. Our data is right here, so we're going to go with From Sheet. This is going to bring up the Power Query editor. We have our source step here, which was just our table, and Power Query automatically added a change type step for the headers. It just transformed them to text for this and to a whole number for our sales values, which is fine. Now to remove duplicates, I'm going to hold down Shift. So the first column is selected. I'm holding down Shift and I'm going to click on the last column, then right mouse click and remove duplicates. Okay, so everything looks good. Let's call this T-Sales report and send this back to the worksheet. So close and load two. I want to put it on the existing worksheet. Let's put it right here so we can compare the results and click on OK. It says 15 rows were loaded. Now something is different. Can you spot the additional row? It's right here. In this case, bridge was written with a small b instead of a capital B. So this line was not seen as a duplicate, even though it exists up here. This is something you have to keep in mind when you use Power Query and you're removing duplicates there, because the formula version sees these as the same thing. It's not case sensitive. The remove duplicates feature from the data tab is also not case sensitive, but Power Query is case sensitive. So if we want to remove the duplicate right here, we need to add an additional step in Power Query to get this to work correctly. So let's go back to our query. So bring up queries and connections. I'm just going to double click to bring up the Power Query editor and jump back a step to change type. So right before removing duplicates, I need to make sure that everything has the same case. In this example, the problem applies to sales agent, not to region. But if you have multiple columns that could have a different letter case, you need to apply this step that I'm going to show you to the other columns as well. And that step is to transform the column to make sure the content of the column is in the same case. So I clicked on the Transform tab. I have this already selected. I'm going to go to Format here and select a format that's common to the whole column. We can put everything in uppercase, lowercase. In this case, it makes sense to capitalize each word. So I'm going to go with that. It asked me if I want to insert a step in between these two. Yes, I do. Okay, so now our bridge here is capitalized. So when we go to remove duplicates, it's automatically removed. So let's go and send back the result to Excel. Just click on close and load. And now we get the same result. Okay, now we can also test how this updates when we add something new to this. So I'm going to copy and paste this here. Let's change this to 50. Formula version automatically updates. This version doesn't automatically update. I have to right mouse click, select refresh, and I get the new data show up here. As you can see, there are different ways you can remove duplicates. Use the one that suits your Excel version and also your process. Also remember that Power Query is case sensitive. Okay, so that's it for today. Give this video a like, do subscribe if you're unsubscribed already, and I'm gonna see you in the next video.